I'm tracking Splinter the rat snake, and boy, has he moved. I'm way up on a Forest Service road, oh, probably, I don't know, half a mile from the nature center. That's a guess. I haven't pulled out the GPS to confirm that, but it's a good ways. So, gotta head into the woods here and see if I can find him. He's probably up in a big tree, but then again, who knows? Pretty warm day. He might be down low. I hope the leaf will be okay sitting there on the side of this road, but I guess we'll find out. Straight ahead into the forest. Sun is on my right. Sun needs to be on my left coming out. I mean, I could, you know, GPS mark my car, but when the sun's there, I don't need to worry about that. Oh, I'm getting really close now. Oh, I think I found it. I think I found where he might be. See that oak? Look up near the, where that limb forks off to the right. You see that hole? He might be prowling around for birds and squirrels in that old oak. Or that could just be his lair. Wow, yeah, I think we found it. It's old oak. One way to find out. Go past it. He is close by. Look at that. Loud hit on that oak, and it fades. I think that's where he is. All right, so what I'm going to do is circle the oak. And as I circle it, I'll periodically turn back towards it like that. See, watch. And I get a really loud hit when I turn back towards the oak. If I go around the tree and in three or four different places, I turn back towards the oak and get a loud signal, turn away from the oak and get a quiet signal, then I'm pretty sure it's going to be that oak. Kind of like a bullseye effect because he's up high. I really believe he's in that oak. After I've circled the tree and I can't find him anywhere on the ground, but the oak seems to be giving me the strongest signal. It also has lots of knot holes, access points where the snake could crawl inside the tree into a tree cavity and take shelter. I wish I could see him to confirm that he's in there, but if you look up, way up, you can see that hole that I mentioned earlier. I believe he's in there, in one of those holes. There's several holes. So So I think that's where he's taking shelter. Or he could be stretched out on a limb, as I said before. I just wish I could see him. But, you know, the Cherokee called this snake the climber for a good reason. Because he's a very good climber, and he climbs to look for food, such as rodents, birds, and bats. All right, so I'm going to go over, lean back against the tree, and collect my data. He's up there somewhere, I believe. Take a look. All right, I have no way of measuring the temperature of the tree limb that he's laying on or the cavity that he's in. So all I can do is take the temperature of the ground, the base of the tree. Get a GPS coordinate. I'll get the temperature of the soil because you just never know when that data point is going to be needed. Okay, so Splinter has moved a quarter of a mile to the northeast from his day two location at that big pine tree where we found him with the students in class. And he is really not that far from a Forest Service road, which kind of worries me a little bit. But hey, I've got to let him do what he's going to do. Can't protect him. This is a project that is following a wild black rat snake in his native habitat. And more than likely, he's going to stay in the forest. But then again, we don't know that. That's why we're doing the study. Okay, well, I'm out tracking Splinter, the rat snake, again, and I've tracked him quite a distance from the nature center. I'm in the middle of a mixed hardwood forest, not quite sure where I am. I'd have to pull up the GPS to know that. And I have walked into a huge rhododendron thicket above a spring head, it looks like. And I'm getting a really strong signal, so he's somewhere in the area. So let's see if we can find him. Check this out, guys. An ancient old hemlock tree has fallen here.
From what?
Well, for one, the tree was killed by the hemlock woolly adelgid. And then it was knocked down in a storm.
How do you know it was a hemlock woolly adelgid?
Because all the hemlocks are being killed by the adelgid. And this is one of them.
It's like this little, arthropod.
It's almost like an aphid, yeah.
It's like a non-insect aphid.
Okay.
I've been seeing a lot of male winged aphids.
It's that time of the year. We're getting a really strong signal right in here. He might be right in here. Really strong. Hear that? Mm-hmm. And I'm kind of astonished. At the location where I believe I've found Master Splinter. The same location where he was a couple of weeks ago. Come on up this way, towards my voice, up the hill. So yeah, that big oak tree right there. I'm getting a strong signal from that same tree. Crazy. Yep, I believe he's still in his big oak. Amazing. It's been like 2.5 weeks or so, and he's still here. I guess he's finding everything he needs in this wonderful old tree. So I'll just need to collect my data and come back again in a couple of weeks. Amazing.